fact of the Nation of Islam being able to sustain itself over such a long period of time, institutionalizing their different programs, etc., on the one hand. And on the other hand, the Tulsa, Oklahoma massacre of 1919, sometimes referred to as the Black Wall Street, which World War I soldiers come back armed, black soldiers, and there's a massacre that still is not widely known enough. The Red Summer, right? So how do those two examples fit into your framework?
Sure thing.
I'll start with the latter. So the Tulsa case, I'm sure many of you are already aware, so this is probably redundant. There's a reparations case ongoing. And it's being led by this reparations commission that includes a number of people, including this lawyer, Harvard lawyer, who's not doing physically well right now, but they're pushing ahead this case reparations for what happened in that so-called Black Wall Street zone, right? In fact, there's actually video where you can see the smoke and the burning from the buildings. If you go online, you can see some of the video from that, and that was over, what, several days of massacre and violence. And so the reparations piece fits in, but my challenge to reparations debate is that they're talking about the wrong thing. Mm. The question is not, should people of African descent get paid or not? Right. The question is, reparations should mean, you know, not a paycheck. Right. Which is simply paying people off. But reparations should be, you know, widespread challenging of power and transformation.
Yeah.
Because slavery didn't just touch Wall Street, right? Okay. I teach at Leaders School, Colgate University, upstate New York. Many Leaders School, Harvard, Yale, Princeton, George Washington, others, that's slave money. Major clothing line, this is Moshu, but Brooks Brothers.
Right.
They used to make the coarse, right, fabrics to feed the enslavement industry.
Right.
Our healthcare.
Mm-hmm.
Modern medicine owes itself to the dead and dying bodies of enslaved that were autopsied.
Right.
It owes itself to plantation physicians that would dig up the graves of newly deceased slave Africans to autopsy them to train the new medical students.
Wow.
Oh, yes. In fact, why do you think there's a African American folklore, which is based on some reality, that they fear your children being snatched? Why do you think people fear going to Johns Hopkins Hospital in Baltimore? It's not because of Freddie Gray alone. It's because Henry Lacks and stories like her. So what I'm trying to say is that reparations has to touch all these institutions to be reparations. And that's not happening, which I think Tulsa is being betrayed. Unless it touches all these institutions that have been wedded to, that have been emboldened, and essentially have assumed their modern forms because of it, right? The other part, which is, you know, this the other part, Tulsa was one, the other one was the
Nation
of right, Nation Islam, right. Nation Islam is an interesting configuration because that one is insular, meaning it's focused on these ideologies, because it's not Orthodox Islam, it's a variety of Islam that have morphed since Elijah Muhammad, Wahdi Muhammad, through Malcolm, and through Farrakhan. And because it's an insular organization, it was the opposite of the East. The East was open to anyone that wanted to do the work. In fact, there was a saying in the 70s that Kazi, which is Kiswahili for work, Kazi is the blackest of them all. Which means if you want to show your blackness, put yourself to work for your people, for your community, right? And so the East was open-ended, much like Weeksville. We want you to buy land, help us to build, help us to grow. The nation is insular. If you fall in line with our ideology, or you are something else, right? And so that insularity works against community. I think it's anti-community.
Right.
To an extent, it's almost, what, elitist,
right?
Right?